And I said to the sex therapist, why do I always attract girls with mental illness? Simping is more contagious than COVID. I think he's uncomfortable. This is so relatable. You're either autistic or narcissistic. You can't really be both. It's gonna be the biggest fuckboy in 3 years time. Look at her fucking face. This is so cute. They need to just get married. Hey guys, it's BJ, your favorite autistic comedian. And today I'm watching Love on the Spectrum, an autism-themed dating show. And I'm gonna give you my honest feedback on how I feel about this show and the way autistic people are portrayed. Are you ready?
My name is Danny. I am 26 years old. I am on the autism spectrum.
Yay.
I wanted to find somebody special, somebody who can depend on me. We want to depend on each other and work together.
Codependent is creepy. This bitch is looking for a codependent relationship, and I'm not interested.
I need somebody who's financially secure, who can maintain a company.
You're not being a gold digger, are you, Danny?
Yeah.
What? Yeah. You know, what a gold digger is?
Gold digger means they're trying to look for guys who are rich.
Yes.
Is that you?
Pretty much, but...
Yeah. Do you remember your practice boyfriend?
Hey, puppy.
Well, I do.
What's a practice boyfriend, Danny?
A practice boyfriend is somebody that you use for practicing.
So she's using a guy. You never use people. The only time I've ever used a girl was when I used to have Barbie dolls when I was a little boy and I'd give them cunnilingus to prepare me for the real thing. Ellie.
To her, it was just practice. To him, it was like, yeah. I have a girlfriend.
I didn't say.
This bitch is using men. She's using all these other guys to prepare her for when she meets the right guy, and that's unacceptable. That is not gonna work out well in the end.
My ideal partner would be somebody who is running another company. Not only we see each other like lovers, but also work partners.
Yes. Danny just needs to find a guy that's ambitious. But I hope her standards aren't too high because she's gonna be disappointed because people are cunts.
Danny is meeting her good friend Devon for a drink.
Bonjour.
Well, she drinks alcohol, so she's now in the friend zone because I only date Muslim girls that don't drink, so she's haram.
I wanna hear about your dating life.
Okay.
How has that been going?
A lot of people on the autism spectrum think I'm too smart and too motivated, while neurotypicals think I'm too strange. Just want to be sure that they're motivated enough and have a good sense of hygiene.
I find that so relatable because a lot of people tell me that I'm too motivated as well, but at the end of the day, life is so short, and why would you want to waste your time doing things that don't bring you a purpose? So this girl is very relatable. She needs to get off the alcohol and come to BJ.
Danny is meeting Solomon. He likes writing poetry and good vibes.
I like good
vibes.
He
doesn't
like
messy eaters or aggressive birds.
I like this guy already.
My name is Solomon.
I'm Danny. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Oh,
good for you.
Flowers,
he's a simp. You don't give a bitch flowers on the first date. She's got to earn the flowers. You don't just give the girl flowers. Is she just giving you a blowjob? No. Stop being a simp. Oh my God, she's going to lose interest soon.
Do you like anime?
Yeah, I watch some of it. Not all the time, though.
Anime
porn. Have you ever been to San Diego Comic-Con?
I have, yeah.
You did?
Yeah, it's really nice.
Oh my goodness. I gotta use the restroom for a second.
It's
Be
okay.
right back. Sullivan, oh, he is so attractive. I mean, oh, I'm just so nervous and, oh, by the way, I'm just in love. We also share lots of hobbies.
Did you say you're in love?
Yes.
That's so soon.
Hey, I'm back.
Hey.
Maybe she's gonna love bomb him, but then again, I don't think autistic people are capable of love bombing. As an autistic person, I just say what I'm thinking. So when I find a girl attractive, I just tell her. And I really hope that this girl goes back to that chair and tells that guy how much she really likes him. So I don't think autistic people are capable of love bombing. They just have really intense feelings and sometimes they process them in a way that might come across as unconventional and awkward. So I really hope he isn't horrible to her and I hope that they get along really well.
Because you know I told you that I'm in spirituality and all that, right?
Yes, you sure did.
Dude, I reckon he's gonna be the biggest fuckboy in 3 years' time. Like, he's got so much potential. He's just gotta start putting himself out there. I feel like once he starts dating, he's gonna be like, damn, I wish I started earlier. I really believe in this guy. I think he's gonna make a great fuckboy. And I'm proud of him for getting outside his comfort zone. He has nice hair.
I love it. It's like, literally, I listen to you. You okay?
I am in love with you.
Oh. Huh?
Dude, you don't just tell the guy straight away you love him. Because what if you go on another date with another guy and you like him even more and you tell him that you love him as well? This guy's gonna feel lied to. You don't even know if this is really him. This could be a whole facade. Bitch, you need to stop telling a guy that you love them straight away. Cool off.
What?
Fuck. I think he's uncomfortable. Fuck, this is so relatable. Yeah, because some autistic girl wanted to date me, but I wasn't interested because she wasn't Muslim or Middle Eastern. Fuck, this is gonna turn into an obsession. I'm worried about this girl. Some autistic people, when they have a crush on someone, that crush becomes their obsession. I don't do that. It's okay to admire that person, but this full-on blown obsession is unacceptable and unhealthy. You're gonna go down a rabbit hole of disappointment. Please, baby girl, stop this.
What's up, Solomon?
Oh, I just want to take a little break.
Yeah, sure.
I'm sorry.
He's so uncomfortable.
Break, take a break.
Fuck.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. The situation's a little awkward.
Fuck, dude.
Yeah, I'm so sorry.
It's okay.
Can I just tell you something?
Yeah, go ahead.
You look really great.
No, he's a simp. Simping is more contagious than COVID.
Thank you so much, and you do too.
Wow, thank you.
Good looking.
Is it cool if I read you a poem of mine that I kind of wrote? Because I'm really passionate about my writing. Is it cool?
Yeah.
Fuck.
All right, I just wanted to tell you that I'm clinging to your beautiful, divine, lovely soul. You're the most magnificent, lovely girl in the world. With so many beautiful jewels and stars in your soul and heart. It's like you're a precious angel out of the blue. Don't forget how amazing, precious, divine, beautiful girl that's made for eternity.
That describes me. It made lots of sense.
She's a narcissist. No, autistic people can't be narcissistic. You're either autistic or narcissistic. You can't really be both.
And I think you would be the right guy. A good fit.
Wow.
Fuck. I haven't simped this hard over a girl since I was in kindergarten. Are they gonna fuck though? Like there's obviously an emotional connection, but what are they gonna be like sexually with each other? I'm really, really curious to see what happens. I wonder, I love foreplay. When I like a girl, I have like a big Word document where I write up how I'm gonna fuck her and I just read it every night before I go to bed and then I fall asleep and have a wet dream and have lucid dreams where I fuck her. Doing whatever I wrote on that Word document. It's such a great way to live.
Oh, dear.
This law of attraction just probably bought the right soulmate for me. And like, wow, like, you know?
This is so
I
hot.
Got the giggles.
She's gonna have a lot of fun pulling his hair when they fuck.
Gosh, I think I found the right match. The soulmate's here. It's like some Prince Charming just comes to me. It's coming.
You okay?
Oh, dude, she needs to finger
herself. For you.
I love the direct bluntness. This is fucking great. This is why people should date autistic people. So, like, I went to see a sex therapist last year. And I said to the sex therapist, why do I always attract girls with mental illness and stuff like that? Especially girls that have been abused. And the sex therapist said to me, BJ, for a girl that's been abused or in an unhealthy relationship, it's actually a very good idea for her to date a guy with autism because men with autism are very direct and you know where you stand with them. And that's very perfect for a girl that's been abused. And autistic people are very therapeutic for girls with mental illness. So if you're a girl with mental illness, get an autistic boyfriend and delete Tinder. You'll thank me later.
Good for you. Falling for you.
That's perfect.
Now you make my heart explode.
I will make your beautiful heart happy.
Like I could hug you.
Oh, this is so cute.
You want
I was thinking it was cringeworthy, but since it's mutual, it's okay. Like if she was a psycho who was obsessed with him and he was uncomfortable with it, it would be creepy. But the fact that it's mutual, I'm like, you know what? Let these two autistic people have fun.
My heart's telling me that I should kiss this beautiful divine girl and that's you.
If my eyes are closed, within to the mind.
Like right now?
Sullivan.
Kiss her. Great fucking night tonight.
I'm like...
Look, she's climaxing. Look at her, she's climaxing. Look at her fucking face. She's climaxing. Just start pulling his hair and oh my God. I think this guy and this girl, they need to just get married. But what if the sex is bad? What if he doesn't know what he's doing? Fuck. I reckon she's the sort of girl that's so obsessed, she'll just enjoy whatever. Like, he could do the most basic missionary shit and she'd still be happy. Whereas BJ, I like roleplay.
I feel it.
Yep, she's
I
definitely
can feel it.
Yeah, she can.
It's like my heart's telling me.
Oh my God, that's so cute. Kiss her neck. Neck's more fucking sensitive.
Can I hug you enough?
You can.
This is so cute.
We need to get to know each other a little bit more.
I love, fuck. That is the most autistic thing I've heard in my life.
It went pretty well, it seems like.
It went pretty well. Like, I'm like all fluttered and like, oh my gosh. That's love on my first blind date. There's nothing to be nervous about when you're...
I reckon she's gonna go on another blind date and find someone that she likes even more, and poor little Sullivan guy's gonna be heartbroken and left alone.
Feeling really good. Like, literally the best moment in my life.
Is that your first kiss?
Yeah, I'm being honest, dude. It's my first kiss.
I had my first kiss on the 26th of May 2012 when I was 16 years old. And it was at a school dance and it was great. I went on a fucking date to Baskin Robbins with the girl I first hooked up with, but it didn't work out. I lost interest because I have a career. Not my type. Sorry, baby girl.
I have so much to tell my mom and dad tonight.
Now he's getting the parents involved. Fucking hell. This is gonna end very badly. Love on the Spectrum, shorty. Thank you for watching.